President Thomas S. Monson, president of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, will not attend General Conference this year, a church spokesman confirmed Thursday afternoon. The church had previously announced in May that Monson would no longer be attending daily church meetings because of limitations incident to his age. Monson reached a milestone birthday August 21, when he turned 90 years old. For more than half a century, he has served as an apostle of the Lord, including conducting and giving several talks and general conferences. Seeing his empty chair near the podium of the LDS Conference Center gives some members pause and builds concern within them for the welfare of their prophet. Members of the church are also known to hang on every word from the mouth of the prophet. Hearing the voice and seeing the face of their leader is important to them. However, it is not uncommon for older prophets to refrain from activities that are often physically difficult for them to attend. President David O. McKay was frail for many years as he served in his old age. His last message to the saints was read by his son Robert R. McKay during the October 1969 semi-annual General Conference. McKay died January 18, 1970, at the age of 96. During the Sunday afternoon session of LDS General Conference of April 1972, President Joseph Fielding Smith spoke boldly of Christ and responsibility of the saints. It would be the last time he would address the church. Smith died July 2, 1972, at the age of 95. Smith's final testimony included the following: "I pray that the Lord will bless all the members of the church. And by virtue of the keys and power which I hold, I bless the saints, those who dwell in the household of faith, those who love and seek the Lord." Considered young by church standards, President Harold B. Lee died December 26, 1973. He was 74 years old. His last public words to the church membership were given 2 months earlier at the October 1973 semi-annual General Conference. He ended conference with these words: "Peace be with you, not the peace that comes from the legislation in the halls of Congress, but the peace that comes in the way that the Master said, by overcoming all the things of the world." When prophets have been unable to speak or attend conferences in person, others have been asked to read for them. Such was the case with President Spencer W. Kimball and Ezra Taft Benson. Kimball attended some meetings but did not speak. His last message to the church membership was during the October 1982 semi-annual General Conference. In this case, the prophet's secretary, D. Arthur Haycock, read Kimball's prepared talk. Kimball died 3 years later on November 5, 1985, at age 90. Benson spoke to the elderly in his last prepared message. It was during the October 1989 semi-annual General Conference. The talk was read by Benson's second counselor, Thomas S. Monson. It wasn't until more than 4 years later the prophet, then 94, died on May 30, 1994. Perhaps the most poignant of any modern conference moment came during the solemn assembly of the October 1994 conference. It was at that conference that President Howard W. Hunter, 87, was sustained as prophet. He gave his first and last talk during that weekend. Hunter died March 3, 1995 of cancer. His final testimony was given in the Sunday afternoon session: "And now, my beloved brothers and sisters, through the power and authority of the priesthood vested in me, and by virtue of the calling which I now hold, I invoke my blessings upon you. I bless you in your efforts to live a more Christ-like life. I bless you with an increased desire to be worthy of a temple, recommend and to attend the temple as frequently as circumstances allow. I bless you to receive the peace of our Heavenly Father in your homes, and to be guided in teaching your families to follow the Master." President Gordon B. Hinckley used a walking cane during his last years, but he said it was mostly used for pointing or extending a wave. Hinckley stood strong and was an inspiration to the LDS faithful as he reached 97 years and became the oldest prophet in church history. His last talk was given in the October 2007 semi-annual General Conference.